Tutorial time.
Tutorial time. Dance Gavin Dance, Midnight Crusade. Because this song is in standard tuning. There's your E. Okay, let's get cracking. Intro. Okay, so this intro is essentially made up of four chords. The first of which is a G sharp minor 7 chord. So if you download the tabs, and then you can follow it through with me as I'm going. So I'll quickly describe what notes are in there, but you can follow it on the tab. So your notes are 9, 4, 6, and then reach your middle finger back to a 4 on your low E string. Okay, the reason I do that is because we don't want a note on your A string. And doing it anyway with a bar, sort of, it puts notes in that we don't want. Okay, so if you get those and then reach back like that, I suppose you could try and do it with your thumb, but it's an awkward thing to do. So for me, that's the easiest fingering for it. But if you work something else out that works for you, go for it. Second chord is an E major 7 chord. So we have an open E string, and then we have 11 on your A, and then 9, and then 8. Okay, quite straightforward, that one. And then your third chord is a B major 7 chord. Now this one is 6, 7, 8, 9. Okay, with then a low B. Again, we don't want anything on your A string, so we don't want to bar anything too much. Although I play it with a bar, but I kind of bridge my finger across two frets like this. So I play B on your low E string with the tip of my finger, and then the back end of my finger, I'm doing your A sharp on your high E string, and then filling the notes in with my other three. Okay, so those three chords together. So G sharp minor 7. It's your E major 7. It's your B major 7. And then this next part is kind of based around an F sharp major. But what we actually have is we have an F sharp note on the bottom, and then a little melody on the top. Okay, which goes through like that. So I get one finger playing that F sharp, and then muting all the rest of the strings with the rest of that finger, and then get these three fingers playing that melody. Okay, a little bit awkward, that one. So I suppose you can just strum that for the sake of making it a bit easier so you can play along with the song sooner. So all together, that intro. So you have G sharp minor 7. We have E major 7. We have a B major 7. Then we have your little F sharp. Playing through with that melody on top. Okay, and then we go through that one more time. Only we pause halfway through that F sharp part with your sus 4. And then we stop, and then we kick into the verse. Okay, so there are two guitar parts throughout the whole of the rest of this song. So I'm going to break down each of them individually for each section. Okay, so guitar 1 on the verse. Okay, plays through several chords. They're all relatively straightforward, and they're just picked through. So we start with your G sharp minor 7, or G sharp minor again. But with an E, open E string on top, and we pick through. Okay, you're just kind of picking up then down the chord. And then that moves to. Okay. Same thing on top, but with an open E and an octave E just there. So we have. Okay. So that's your first chord. That's your second chord. And then your third chord, we move up to an E major 7. Up here, which is a different, same chord as this, different inversion. Okay, so we have 7, starting from your A string. 7, 6, 8, and 7. Okay, so that first section. After then, we move to what is essentially the same as that first chord, that G sharp, but we move the G sharp to a C sharp, making it like a C sharp minor 9. Okay, and again, picking's the same. And then that 4 moves down to a 2. So it goes from C sharp to B. Okay, so all together. Okay, and then we have... Okay, that little pattern there, which is 2 4s on your middle 2 strings with an open E string, again muting this A string. Okay, and then we go to that F sharp major sort of shape again. It's just an F sharp major. All we're doing is we don't want this A string, so we're just playing those two notes just like that. Okay, so all together, that verse, guitar 1. Okay, so that's guitar 1. And then guitar 2, which I believe is Martin's guitar. So I think that's Will's guitar. That's what Will's doing. And then Martin's doing the other part. So the other part is based largely around octave chords. So your first octave chord is the G sharp. Okay. And then from there we slide up to 9. And then do 8 on your G. And it's the same thing, but a different little lick on the end, which goes 9, 8 on your G, and then 9 on your D. So those two. Okay, and then we do like an E octave chord with kind of that 9-8-9-8 that you've just done a second ago. And then we go to a 6 with the octave. Okay, and then we're on like a C sharp minor. And that minor 7 moves to a 6, so we go. Okay, with that C sharp there. So that's 9th fret and 8th fret on your G. And then the same thing, but that C sharp moves to a B. And then again, octave. So that's a 6 on your A with the octave. And then a 4 on your A with the octave. And then we go. This chord, which is essentially a B major over D sharp. Okay, all of that together. There you go, and that is your verse. That's both guitars. So let's move on to your pre-chorus. So your pre-chorus, Martin's guitar on the right-hand side. Two chords, very, very simple. We have an E. And then we move up to that F-sharp major with your bar chord. But instead of barring all of it, we want to lift the bar off to get two open strings on top. Okay, so it's just one strum and you hold that for all of that section. Okay, and then the other guitar, Will's guitar. Plays the same two chords that come at the end of the verse. So it's a open E with your 2 4s. Okay, just a different rhythm. And then we go to that F sharp. And then there's a couple of notes I've added on. So on that last time, you reach up to a 6 on your G. Just to kind of create a bit more melody over the top of it. Again, I tend to improvise around. When I tab things out, I tab a certain way of doing it. And then when I actually play it, I just tend to improvise around it a little bit. Okay, so these are all kind of roughly what I like to do in the song. And that's it. The whole of the bridge is just those two parts. So straight after that, we are into the chorus. So the chorus, guitar one, which is the rhythm guitar. Again, this is the left-hand side guitar. So if you want to hear it in more detail, pan the song to the left and you'll hear this guitar more. Chord-wise, very similar to what happens in the verse. So we have your G-sharp minor. And then to that kind of E sort of thing, with your E and your octave E, but still keeping those to one. And then we do a B, adding on the major 7 up at the top. Again, if you want to, or if you can, depending if you can reach it, with your little finger. And then the F sharp with a little improvised thing. Okay, around the same thing, like what you do in the intro. Okay, so again, I improvise it. I can't remember exactly what I did on the tab, but it was something like that. So you can play around with that. So that chorus. It's just twice around that. So that's the rhythm part. That's all quite straightforward. And then the lead part, which sounds a bit like a tappy sort of section when you first listen to it, but I don't believe it is. So I just play it just with single notes. Okay? And these notes are. Okay, so we start with 7, down to a 4 on your E string, and then 4th fret on your B string. Okay? And then we move that 7 to a 6. That's your second one. Your third one is to a 2 on your B, and then a 3 and a 4 on your G. And then we jump to 4, 4, 6, and then 4, 5, 7, 4, 5, 7. Okay, so all together. Okay, and then your second part reverses that 7, 5, and 4. And then we go back to the 2, 3, and 4. And then we do the first two that we did, the 7 and 4. And then your 6, 4, and 4. So all together we have 7, and then 6, and then 2, 3, 4. Then 4, 4, 6, 4, 5, 7, and then. And that's it for your chorus. So they're the two guitar parts. The lead part is on the right, and the other one is on the left. And then from there, it pretty much just repeats your verse, and then your bridge with the same thing, but a slightly different rhythm. I think second time it goes. Instead of. Okay, so just listen out for the rhythm change, but chord-wise, it's the same. And again, those chords are the same as well. And then it's chorus again, which is exactly the same as the one we've just done. And then we are onto the clean guitar section. Okay, so your clean section starts with that B major 7 chord again. So 6, 7, 8, 9. And we pick down the chord, 2 notes on each. And then we move to an E major 7 chord, okay, which is 7, 9, 8, 9, another inversion of E major 7, because we've had that one, and we've had that one, and now we've got this one. All the same chord. And we pick down that chord. Okay, just like we did with the B major 7. And then we're adding an 11 and a 9 on top of that. Okay, quite awkward to mute these notes, particularly that B string. Although, doesn't matter that much if you get it, but you want to try and mute it if you can. Okay, so that first part. Then we strum that E major 7 again. And then we move up to, which is 13, 12, and 14. And then we just drop back to an 11 on your B. Okay, so all together. Okay, and that is guitar one. Again, that's on the left. I think that's Will's guitar part. And then Martin's guitar part, the other side, is quite a difficult little lead section. For some reason, it took me ages to remember how to play it. I just kept playing it wrong. So it's a weird one. It just eludes my memory as I try and put it together. But the first part, anyway. Okay, so we're kind of building up that G sharp minor chord again. Okay, but picking through some different notes as a melody. So your first one is 13 on your D, down to 11 on your A. And then we go 13 on your G, down to 9 on your D. Again, this is how I play it, this is how it fits my fingers. If you find other ways to play these, do it that way, that's fine. And then we do 12 and 13 on your B and G. So. So that's your first part. Okay, now your next part is made up of lots of little snippets of three notes at a time. Okay, so we have. Okay, that is your pattern. Again, follow it through on the tab. We have 12, 11, and 14, followed by 12, 14, and 11. We have 11, 13 on your G, and then skip a string to 11 on your top E. Then your next one goes 13 on your D, G, and then 14 on your B. Okay, so that's your first half. Then your second half goes 12, 14, and 11, followed by 14, 11, skip a string down to 13. And then we're going 16, 14, 13, down your string. Okay, so. Then we do that one, same as the first one, 12, 14, 11. So all together. And the second half. Okay, so each one of these comes in on the offbeat of the one. So it's one and two and three and four and two and three and four and. So it's just getting that time in that's a little bit awkward with that section. And that's it for your clean section. So that bit and then. And so on. Okay, and from there we are into the end section. So that's the first part of the end bit. You just need to get used to doing the rhythm of this because the diddle-dum is quite quick. And then you've got like crotchet triplets. Da, 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 da. Okay, which is a slightly odd rhythm to time with your picking. So yeah, just listen out for those and try and get it nice and tight. Okay, so your first one's a power chord. These are all just power chords on G sharp. So it's da, 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 dum. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, and then crotchet triplets, dum, 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 so 1, dum, dum. And then we go up to B, 7th fret, and down to F sharp, 2nd fret, and then down to open E. Okay, so that's your first section. Okay, then your second section follows in a similar way, but the chords change. So we have start on your open E. Okay, the rhythm's the same. Diddle-diddle-dum, dum-dum-dum, diddle-diddle-dum, diddle-diddle-dum. And then we get down to an F sharp. And then we need an E flat. So you could go to an E flat on your A string, which is what I think I put in the tab. But I like to go up to and then slide back down. So an E flat on your E string, which would be the 11th fret. So it doesn't do that in this song, but I quite like the sound of it. It sounds quite cool. So that's it for the end section. It's just those two parts, and then we finish the whole song on an E. And then the other guitar part for the end section, the rhythm just follows everything the same as the other ones. Okay, so same rhythm, we are going on an octave chord. Okay, so it's a D sharp octave chord, so 6th fret. And then we go to like a little minor second, a little disc chord, which is a 5 and an 8 on your B and G. So it's, and then we go another octave chord, okay, which is A sharp this time, so the 8th fret on your D string, and then we go to an F sharp on your A string, which is your 9th fret, again octave chord. So we have, that last one's back on that D sharp again, that 6th fret. Okay, and that's it for your first half. And then your second half. This one is like an E sus2 chord. Okay, which is a 7, 9, and 11, starting from your A string. Again, same rhythm. And we go to this one here. Okay, which is it's just a B major chord essentially. Okay, so it's like a power chord on the 9th fret on your D string. And then we add on your D sharp, which is your major 7 on the top. Not your major 7, your major 3rd. And then that D sharp drops back to a C sharp. Okay, getting rid of that 3rd. I'm playing a 2 instead. So. And then it's kind of the same rhythm, but you don't do that first chord. You stay on this one, okay? Stay on that B major type shape. So. Okay, and again that one. Just end on an E. I think I did something like that. It's like a major 7 that you end on. Okay, I think I did a power chord, an octave chord. Something in the tab, whatever I did in the tab, you can do that. But essentially, it's an E chord. Okay? Just like the other guitar. And there we go. That is your tutorial for Midnight Crusade. See you soon. Just like we did with the B major 7, and then we're adding an 11 and a 9 on, and then we're adding an 11 and a 9.